NGINX is a fast and efficient HTTP server. We can quickly publish our website on the internet with its help. But do you know how to configure it in a correct and secure way? In today's episode of From Zero to Pentesting Hero, some examples of misconfigurations that may expose us to attacks. In this example, I already assume that you have a server installed and it displays an example page on localhost. We will start with the alias directive. It can be used to map another location. Let's look at an example. Using the location syntax, we define that if a user enters our server using an address that starts with the phrase, then the content that will be displayed will come from the home test NGINX directory. To test this, I create a 1.html file in this directory. After going to phrase/1.html, I can see its content. But there is one tiny hitch. Did you notice that I didn't add a trailing slash after the phrase? What does this change? Without this, we are vulnerable to the path traversal attack, that is, the ability to view files from a different location than the one we would like. To prove this, I will create a 2.html file in the home/test directory. Now just enter the location using double dot after phrase. As you can see, I displayed the contents of the 2.html file, despite the fact that it is placed in a different directory that was defined in the alias directive. To correct this error, always end the addresses with a slash. The second example is about security headers added automatically to response from the server. In our case, I set the X-frame options header to avoid a clickjacking attack. If you don't know what this attack is, you can watch my previous video on this topic, the link can be found in the description. Thanks to the addHeader functionality, each server response has a valid header. But are you sure? Let's say that I want to add a header responsible for XSS support in the browser to the standard headers, and I want it only in the XSS location. So I add an additional header using the addHeader. It is clear that the server should sum up these headers, so the response should include a header from the parent field and the additional one from the child field. But NGINX works differently, and it displays only the headers from the secondary field, which in some cases can lead to the serious errors, just like here, where our site is no longer protected against clickjacking attacks. The third example shows how the string comparison works. Let's suppose there is an admin panel at admin.local and it can be used only by a person using one static IP address. So we create two ifs. In the first one, we check if the user attempts to visit the admin.local page. In the second, we check if his IP address is different than 10.10.10.10. If both conditions are met, it means that he wants to visit the admin panel without being authorized to do so. So we return the proper header and finish the execution of the configuration file. Now, you are probably wondering what this weird block variable means. It is not possible to use two conditions in the if statement in NGINX, and that's the workaround. And indeed, our configuration works properly. If we try to enter the given domain, we got an error, our IP address doesn't match. How to bypass this protection? We use tilde to compare characters and it is case sensitive. So instead of visiting the admin.local page, we can try to enter the admin.local in capital letters, that is how we are able to bypass it. The fourth mistake is related to regular expressions. I have warned you many times, if you use them, be wary. In this case, if the request comes from the admin.local domain, we return the appropriate course headers to allow for AJAX request to this domain. We can use the regular expressions to check the origin header. Can you find a mistake? Let's analyze this expression together. It must start with HTTP admin and then the .local. In regular expressions, the dot means any single character. But here, we have the ordinary dot because it was preceded by backslash. But here we check only the beginning of the header, because the dollar sign is missing and it marks the end of the string. So it is possible to create a domain which name will start with admin.local and at the same time it will be a subdomain of another domain. For example, this expression will also work for admin.local.shurek.pl, allowing for AJAX requests also from this domain. That is why it's important to remember about the dollar sign. The last example for today is also the most complex. We can set up the server to support PHP files. Such files will be sent to the appropriate PHP interpreter. There are many tutorials on the internet, but not all of them are correct. Let's look at this example. I put a simple file in the user share nginx html test.php directory. It returns the correct time. As you can see, everything works as it should. We are going to try to rename this file to the test.png and try again. Of course, this will not work, because NGINX only supports files with the PHP extension. But are you sure? We will now use a different URL. It starts with the name of our image, then the slash, and then the name of the non-existent PHP file. NGINX will try to execute it as PHP because it ends with PHP. PHP interpreter will, however, try to execute the first matching file because of the CGI fix path info option. You can read more about this attack on the website that explains this error more comprehensively. It was so frequent that the attack mentioned above will not work in the latest PHP versions. This is due to a change in the limit extensions configuration, which defines which files can be recognized as PHP. Do you know any other configuration mistakes? Share them in a comment. These and other errors are recognized by the little node tool, which is able to validate the configuration files. Link in the description below. Check if you are vulnerable too. And that's all for today. I invite you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. See you in the next episode. Bye!